Hello, welcome to our brief stargazing guide for September. This month, the sky is slowly filling up with autumn objects. Also for September 2022, three out of the five planets that we can see with naked eyes are going to be there for midnight viewers. As usual, we will begin our brief tour of the sky with objects that are bright enough to be seen in light polluted skies, and then proceed to identify related objects that may be too dim for urban viewers. This guide is therefore useful in light polluted skies where only the bright objects can be seen, and dark skies for the less visible details. The illustrations used in this guide present the sky objects as they would appear to a person viewing from about 50 degrees north of equator in September, around 11 p.m. to midnight. They have been obtained from Stellarium app, but can also be accessed through Stellarium web. I have picked Perseus, the hero, in the eastern sky as the main constellation for this guide. As we go out to find Perseus, we will also visit the constellations Cassiopeia, Andromeda, and Pegasus. We will also see the red planet, Mars, which at the reference time of this issue is just rising in the east. In the southwestern sky, we will visit the summer triangle Asterism together with its constellations, Cygnus the Swan and Aquila the Eagle. While straight south, we will find the planet Saturn, and in the southeastern sky, we will find the planet Jupiter. Let us begin with finding the constellation Perseus, the hero. Facing east and turning a little to your left, you will see a bright star that appears to dominate that part of the sky. That star is Capella, the little god. It is the sixth brightest star in the night sky. It is in the constellation Auriga. From Capella, if you raise your eyes further in the rightward direction, you will find five stars that form a distinctive W pattern here. The pattern looks like this. And it is the constellation Cassiopeia, the queen. We can draw a line from Capella to a star in Cassiopeia like this. Halfway on the right of the line we have just drawn, there's a distinguishably bright star that we can connect with lines running from Cassiopeia and Capella to form a triangle shape like this. This star here is called Mirfak, and it is the brightest star in the constellation Perseus. It is a supergiant located about 510 light years from us. On the right downward side of Mirfak is another visibly bright star that we can connect with a line like this. This is the second brightest star in the constellation Perseus, called Algol. If you're watching from a light polluted area like me, you might be able to see these three more stars in the constellation Perseus, but the rest may be too dim. So I'm going to complete the shape of this constellation by running lines connecting the stars we have identified, including some dimmer stars that will be visible to viewers in dark sky areas. First is a line running down from Mirfak like this. Then extension of the line from Mirfak to Algol to two more dimmer stars like this. And lastly, a line from Mirfak in the direction of Cassiopeia to connect with two other stars like this. That completes the shape of the constellation Perseus, the hero. Now, there are bright stars on the right side of Mirfak that we can connect to get an extended line like this. And the fifth one at the end up here. The first three are in the constellation Andromeda, the princess, part of which looks like this. The remaining stars are part of the constellation Pegasus, the flying horse, which from our observation point is upside down looking like this. Turning to the constellation Andromeda, the princess, above this star here is our neighboring galaxy Andromeda, which is located about 2.5 million light years away. You can see Andromeda galaxy with naked eyes if you are in a dark sky area. From the shape of the constellation Pegasus, we can obtain the great square of Pegasus asterism by removing the head and the front legs of the horse like this. Before we leave the eastern sky, let me talk about the red planet Mars, which in September 2022 becomes visible in the east for midnight viewers. Mars is the planet which is very close to Earth, and therefore its motion in the sky against the background objects is much faster than the rest of natural objects, excluding the moon and meteors. In September 2022, Mars will be the brightest reddish-looking object in the constellation Taurus. Below Mars, closer to the eastern horizon, is Aldebaran, the brightest star in the constellation Taurus. We can therefore use Capella and Aldebaran to identify Mars as a bright reddish object moving eastwards between them. To detect the motion of Mars relative to the background stars, you need to compare its position day after day. We'll talk more about the constellation Taurus in the coming months. Now, let us turn to the southern sky. Some of the objects we have discussed in the eastern sky extend to the southern sky. In particular, the constellation Pegasus and the great square of Pegasus asterism. Facing south and raising your eyes to overhead, you will see the summer triangle asterism on your left. With the summer triangle, we can identify the constellations Cygnus, this one, flying in the downward direction, and the constellation Aquila, the Eagle, flying in the opposite direction. For more discussion about these summer objects, see my previous videos. Looking straight in the southern sky, you'll find the planet Saturn as an object that is distinctly brighter compared to the rest of objects in that region. To confirm that you're looking at Saturn, see if you draw a line from it to the tip of the summer triangle asterism, you will get a shape that looks like this. In the southeastern sky, just beneath the great square of Pegasus asterism, is an object that is brighter than all midnight objects except the moon. That is the giant planet Jupiter. Thus, together with Mars, we have three planets visible to our naked eyes at the reference time of this guide. Remember, the positions of the planets relative to the background stars keep on changing, and that is why they were in the ancient times referred to as wandering stars. The closer a planet that we can see at midnight is to us, the faster its position appears to change relative to the background stars. This is partly because of its closeness to us and partly because of its closeness to the Sun, which makes its orbital speed faster. So, like Mars, Jupiter and Saturn are moving eastwards relative to other objects in the sky, but the speed at which the position of Mars is changing is fastest and the speed of Saturn is slowest. At some point, each of these superior planets, that is, planets that are further away from the Sun than Earth, namely Mars, Jupiter and Saturn, performs visible retrograde motion where it temporarily seems to move westwards against the background stars and then resumes the eastward motion. This also applies to the rest of superior planets, namely Uranus and Neptune, only that we cannot see them with naked eyes. The inferior planets also perform retrograde motion, but this happens in the Sun's glare. Lastly, the western sky. If we face west, close to overhead, you will see the summer triangle looking like this. To the right, the Big Dipper asterism is clearly visible here. We use the pointer stars at the end of the Big Dipper to find Polaris by running a line like this until it touches the next bright star. This is Polaris, which marks one end of Ursa Minor constellation. The Ursa Minor constellation, also known as the Little Dipper, runs in the downward direction like this. Between the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper, there is a long winding hard-to-see constellation called Draco, the Dragon. The head of the Dragon is marked by these two stars, which you can easily see close to the bottom right angle of the summer triangle, that is close to the star Vega. Since the rest of the stars in this constellation are very faint, I'll just trace it, and if you are in the dark sky area, you can trace it with me. That completes the shape of the constellation Draco, the dragon. It also brings us to the end of our brief stargazing guide for September. It is my hope that you have enjoyed watching it. If so, please like. I'd also appreciate your comments. Thank you for watching.